Right now, I'm in beautiful San Diego, California, where I'm about to do a group reading for Olivia Munn and her mom. You guys know Olivia as an actress in stuff like Magic Mike, The Newsroom, and she was just recently cast in the next X-Men movie. And if you're a sports fan, you've probably seen her with her boyfriend, Green Bay Packers quarterback Aaron Rodgers.
Hi.
Olivia.
Here she is. So excited to see you.
So excited to see you.
Hey. This is amazing.
I met Olivia a few years ago backstage at a talk show when she introduced herself to me as a super fan of Long Island Medium. As a Mother's Day gift, Olivia got her mom to join us for a very special group reading.
I'm excited to see what happens with some of the people in my family. There's a couple skeptics.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah,
doesn't matter.
My mom's Asian, so she has a thick accent. Okay, and I was like, don't worry, Teresa's good with accents.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Yeah. All right, so you want to get
Yeah, let's do it. I'm so excited.
Nice to meet you. Hi, nice to meet you. You have a beautiful daughter.
Olivia brought me a few skeptics, and walking into that room, I definitely felt that energy.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
I brought the toughest people to Teresa today. I mean, my sister is a lawyer. She graduated magna cum laude. My brother just became a master in physics, and I think that my sister would probably be the biggest skeptic. We've been friends for a couple years now.
Yeah.
We've just bonded and stayed friends, and so my family came to visit, and I thought it would be a great, fun surprise for everybody.
That's great. It's awesome. Do you know what I do for a living? Okay. So I am able to connect with people that have crossed over. And I know that sounds crazy, but they're going to say things, and you're going to go, but wait a minute. There's no way she would have known about it. How did she know that? And they will make me feel things. So you know that it's them. So don't be afraid.
My mom raised us Christian. We were always going to church. But this is a different kind of thing. You know, even people who believe in God don't believe in mediums. We're ready.
Okay, so I'm first gonna actually start with, okay, there's a young male stepping forward. I feel removed from this. It does not always necessarily have to be a family member.
I don't think any of us know any young people.
Okay, he just told me he actually took his own life. So do you know someone that took their own life?
I do.
Okay. You do? Who? Oh, wait, I guess don't say it.
You don't have to. It's fine.
My name is Sarah, and I'm Olivia's sister. I don't have any experience with mediums or anything even remotely supernatural, and so I am a skeptic of mediums.
She's the biggest skeptic. When Teresa was talking about the young male that departed, I knew that this is not us. And then my sister speaks up. All of a sudden, she knows somebody who died and took his own life. Did you know that she had a friend who killed himself?
I didn't remember, but
she doesn't talk about those things.
I didn't talk about that.
So I'm just going to acknowledge the young male that stepped forward. There's something, though, about that young man. He's very persistent. And he just said, please thank her. He might have left the physical world newly in your friendship.
He did.
Okay? But I felt like the time that you knew him, you gave him so much faith.
We got really close for a very short period of time, and then he died.
Okay, and he wants to thank you for that.
I was really shocked. If this was real at all, then she had to be talking about my friend, especially when she raised the issue that it was a suicide. My husband and I had only known him for about 6 months, and he shot himself.
There's a connection with birthday and with him. Do you understand that?
That's when he died.
Okay.
On my birthday.
We had planned on meeting up with him that night and found out from another close friend that this had happened. And finding out that he felt so strongly about me and my husband was really affirming, because both my husband and I felt that we should have maybe tried a little harder to be there for him that one moment.
So is your mom departed?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
How do you understand your mom's ring? Was it something that you wanted?
No.
She told me yes.
I did.
Okay.
You did?
Wow. Yeah, she died with it.
Yeah, that's okay. Right.
You have to understand, when spirit makes me feel that you have...
Why is it all on me? Like, this is very awkward.
Look, I respect completely how you feel.
Right.
I feel you're very spiritually connected, but yet I feel guarded.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
My sister is a very successful lawyer, so it was really fascinating to see her put off guard and not really understanding how Theresa is knowing certain things.
She showed me a mother's ring.
Yeah, it was
for Mother's Day.
Mm-hmm, it was for Mother's Day.
Was there a green stone in there?
Mm-hmm. It had a green stone.
Spirit might just be making Olivia Munn's sister Sarah a believer after all.
Do you have your grandmother's ring? She showed me a mother's ring.
Yeah, it was for
Mother's Day.
Mm-hmm, it was for Mother's Day.
Was there a green stone in there?
Mm-hmm. It had a green stone.
She had a mother's ring that had all of our birthstones in it. She loved that ring, and she spent a lot of time showing it to me and explaining who everyone was and which stone stood for everyone. And so I wanted maybe not even to have it personally, but for it to still be with our family.
For you, your name is John?
Yes.
Do they call you John John?
Yeah, she calls him Mr. John John.
Mr. John John.
Mr. John John, Theresa.
It's Mr. John John to you, Theresa.
Yeah, that's
yeah. Why you call
that's
John
an amazing
John.
Thing, because like John John is a very specific thing that we were just talking about it yesterday, too. It's Mr. John John. Now everyone will know.
Right? Well, do you wear a necklace in memory of a loved one that's departed?
I don't.
Okay. Your mother keeps showing me a necklace.
Yeah, well, I connect with that.
Okay, how do you understand that?
Because it's a piece of jewelry a necklace of my grandmother's that I have. And she actually has it.
It takes with me now.
She took it, she brought it here with us, and it's in her purse.
Perfect.
Yeah, you're not crazy. You just have to say yes if you have one or not gonna. My mom thought that she was in some kind of like this is a magic show. And I was like, no, mom, just answer yes or no. My mom thought she was like, you know, about to see some like a bunny pulled out of a hat or something. I brought you everyone.
Listen,
that's going to challenge you.
Yeah,
no
you.
One's going to answer anything straight. You're welcome.
Your mother made my legs feel numb and started jumping up and down. That's my symbol for that they couldn't move freely here in the physical world, whether they were just bedridden, if they had something amputated.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Do you understand that?
Yeah, she was bedded for a while.
Did she also have an issue with her feet?
Yeah.
Because she keeps telling me, she goes, oh, tell her my feet don't hurt. Because I felt like you would always rub her legs or rub her feet.
Yeah.
In Asian culture, it's really important to take care of everybody, your father, mother, to the end of their life.
It's hard sometimes then when we carry a burden, it's hard for us to be fully happy. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. What's the burden?
You have this burden of caring, making all of these decisions.
Mm-hmm. But it's hard.
It's hard.
Very hard.
Yeah.
My mom is one of 9 kids, and she's the one who stayed with her all day long and took care of her. But nursing homes are not okay in Asian culture. And so she was really devastated by having to make that really hard choice. And when Theresa talked about having to make that hard choice, and that...
We had to take my mom to a nursing home, and after 3 months, she passed away.
Everything that you did for her, everything that you helped her with, she wants to thank you because you made all the right choices. Were you there when her soul actually left the physical body?
Yes.
Because did you tell her it was okay to let go?
I did.
She wants to thank you for that.
Mm-hmm. I had to go.
Because she said, I want you to know that Dad came to greet my soul.
She told me that before she passed away too.
She said what?
My dad, you know, said my husband come in and take me with him.
Oh.
She told me before she passed away.
Mm. How would I know that?
Go, you good.
Because you're good.
I said, yeah, let's go and see my dad.
Because you knew she was getting really sick?
Mm-hmm.
And then how soon after that did she die?
I think about 8 hours. Later.
So you killed her? You told her to go? You just killed her, didn't you? She just pulled the plug.
Buy her a good ticket to go. First class.
Okay.